Now this next one comes from one of the more elaborate plans I dreamed up, and it was from a time when I'd taken my mate Jeff out to catch him his very first marlin.
That's your fish, mate. Keep his mouth in the water, keep his mouth in the water, that way he can breathe. Okay.
Four countries.
Yeah, four countries.
Four countries in 40 days.
There he goes. Look, he's riding himself. He's riding himself and he's swimming away. He's swimming away. Well done, mate.
Well done, mate.
Well done, brother. Yeah!
Loving that, I'm loving it.
It was after this that Jeff revealed that he'd never caught himself a 20-pound snapper, which in New Zealand is like the benchmark fish. And we thought it would be pretty cool and that viewers would relate to following Jeff on this quest to catch his dream fish. And I was pretty confident we could pull it off for him, so I came up with a scheme that was, let's say, a little more entertaining. And like all of our missions though, we started by catching some bait. In this case it was tuna, which is central to the show's theme.
What colour are you putting out?
I was going to put a dark one out.
I'll put a pinky one out there.
Yeah.
Perfect. Now this week, we are after probably the most underutilised fish in New Zealand waters. Whoa, they visit our waters every year, and they are the small tunas, namely the albacore tuna and the skipjack tuna. And this here is a fine example of an albacore. Now, we are going to, oh, you've got a skipjack there.
Yeah.
Oh, no, albacore. Whoa, whoa. Okay, now we are gonna see just how much sport and how many uses we can get out of albacore and skipjack tuna. And if you wanna flick the tuna tubes on for us, mate, we'll keep these fellas alive. Whoa. It looks like I'm gonna get fairly dirty today. Now, to target these small tuna, albacore and skipjack, it's really quite simple. You just need a small, little wee feather lure. They're very inexpensive. And I've just got that tied onto a bit of 60-pound trace and straight onto a hand line. We've got a few marlin lures out today, but we're not terribly worried about marlin. We're after these amazing little tuna. They are so versatile. Now the beauty of using a hand line like me and Peter is that you don't really have to slow the boat down, so as we go throughout the day catching these fish, we're just going to sort of build up a few numbers with some albacore, known as chicken of the sea, fantastic eating, and also great bait, very similar in size to our skipjack tuna, except they've got these big long wide pectoral fins on them here, and these have started us off for at least getting a few baits, eh Pete?
Yeah mate.
Whoa! Okay, see now, there is a great example. We only just got those lures back out. We've got the tuna on the deck, and with the hand lines you can really haul them in. This is in fact how they do it commercially. They hand line them in. And there must be a few here. Okay, Jeff, back up to speed, mate. The lure goes back out. Now what we've got here is a big column of bait fish. Now that bait fish was up on the surface and it's gone down and it's been worked into a big column. You can see on the low frequency side it's quite a dark compact school. This could mean that there's predators around. And out here in summer those predators are usually marlin. But right now we're not after marlin. We're after small tuna. Trouble is the marlin are after the tuna as well.
Marlin just crashed. Oh, smashing the water there.
Smashing the water. Bugger. Bugger, bugger, bugger. Straight ahead. Where that gannet's going to go in now, there must be a big ball. Oh, look at the tails everywhere. There is marlin smashing all through this bait in front of us. There's gannets going in. I can't believe it.
Well, the marlin are just going nuts on the surface over there.
Oh, look at the marlin feeding just here. Oh, right in front of us. Look, right. Oh, we're just about to run a marlin over. At one stage, there was four or five swirls on the top of one.
Hey, bird's going in over there.
Nah, mate, don't worry about those bloody marlin. We're up to skippies, boys. Oh, this is sick. This is sick. Now, catching the skipjack tuna were a key component of pulling off our plan of catching Jeff as 20-pound snapper. But with so many marlin around, we decided we'd have to make a wee diversion from our mission. Now, one of the great uses for a skipjack or an albacore tuna is for a belly flat bait. Now, a belly flat bait is a bait that can be towed or pitched out to a marlin that turns up in the lures. And what we do is we just chop the belly flap out, and once I've got it rigged up, we'll show you just how we can use it. Okay, well, first off, we can knock the heart out. That little nugget is great eating. These belly flaps, when we sew them up, wiggle enticingly for a marlin. And this bit here will save the guts for burley. We can take the fillets off. They're still edible. We've kept that on ice, and they make great snapper bait. And there is our finished bait. I've just got a little wee tiny squid skirt on there. And should a marlin jump up, that can be pitched out overboard. That wobbles around. We give the marlin a chance to eat it and hopefully hook it. We're in the tropics. You'd see a free jumping pilchard from a mile away, wouldn't you?
Yeah, mate.
Oh, on the left! On the left, Marlin! Look! He'll show up on our tow camera.
He's not there.
There he is again. Look at him, right there. Taylor just here. Pull that left flat in and clip the bait on. Pull the left flat in and clip the bait on it and pull that skippy line in.
Good spotting tug.
Yeah, I got the real big. It's a lot. Oh, just peeking out, good bait. We've got one of our live skipjacks out, and that is because we've spotted a marlin swimming along on the surface in this area here. Now, we trolled the lures past and the marlin didn't seem interested, so we've put this live tuna out, and we're just going to see if that's going to rouse his interest. Well done, Mr. Cameron, for spotting the marlin. I take back most of the things I said about you. Now, what I've got here is a drop back in the line, and by that, it literally means I've got this big bit of slack line. I'm holding onto the bait so if it gets bitten, I can let it go, and all this slack line will coil out to give the marlin a chance to eat our bait, because it is a relatively big tuna. Well, big if you're a fish trying to eat it.
The marlin we spotted wasn't interested in eating our live bait, so we went back to the original plan of catching more skipjack and albacore tuna.
Well, we've caught a few albacore and a couple of skipjack now. While we're looking for more, unfortunately we found a few more marlin. So we're going to go past and hopefully they'll leave our marlin lures alone, and there might be some skippies around. Get ready to crank that lure in. He's got the bait. As you can see there, albacore tuna belly flaps are quite good pitch baits. You can see that marlin in behind the lure there, trying to eat the lure. Didn't want to eat the lure, but he wanted to eat my little belly flap bait. Woohoo! Okay, now what we're doing is we're backing up after this fish. We're really backing down hard chasing this fish. We want to get it in as soon as we can so we can get back to our skippy fishing. Nasty bloody marlin. You know, really only reason I threw the bait out was just to show you how good little tuna belly flaps are at catching marlin. Okay, Gary, we've got wind on up. Oh, look at that, that is beautiful. That's a nice striped marlin, all lit up, beautiful thing. Okay, grab the tagpole, someone. Put the tag in them, mate. They're beautiful, tags in them. And now we've got that marlin out of the way, we can carry on with our skippy and albacore fishing. Oh, yeah, we had a bite, mate. Had a bite on the right rigger. Winded it, mate. We're gone?
Yep.
Oh. Okay, push the rigger up a bit, a little bit.
Right,
you're in? No, he's better go. Well, here we go. We've barely got our lures back in the water. And it wasn't another skipjack tuna that popped up, it was another blinking marlin we got a bite from. Might have to find another spot. That's more like it.
Well, quite obviously, the ocean's teeming with life here. Those look to be trevally, just seething, and that's just the very tip of the score that we can see there on the surface.
Oh!
What? Oh, Skippy. Are they Skippies?
They are Skippies, aren't they?
Yeah. Oh, look at them, they're right here. Look, heaps of Skippies. Yes!
Oh,
we found our Skippies. Oh, Pete, you lost our bloody Skippy, mate. What are you doing? Right, let's get us some Skippies, boys. Woo!
Andre!
Yep. Trying to swim, but he's not getting very far. And I'm going to drop him into the finitude, and he can swim downhill until we're ready to use them. Oh, you can see why they're great sport on light tackle, those guys.
Go.
Oh, and the old electric reel's on too. Oh, and this one. Slow right down, mate. Right down. Slow right down. Okay. Oh, look at that. The school, we popped up right in the middle of the shoal. Okay, come on. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. Looks like an albacore, actually. Yeah, albacore. Another albacore, look at that. Wow, that's another albacore to add to. Wow, we've got quite a lot of fish in there now, albacore and skippies. Plenty for snapper bait and burley, but judging by the amount we've got there, I would say there's a bit of processing work involved. You guys are going to have to handle these fish if we catch them? I'm going in.
On the electric.
Yeah. Oh, the little jelly beans, beautiful. Winch him in. Winch him in. Winch him in.
Here she comes.
A little bit of commercial tunering here with the electric reel. Here it is down there. Look at that, way down there deep. It looks like a skippy too, that one. Yes, a skippy. It's a nice skippy. It's a nice skippy.
Oh, he's a fat skippy.
That is a beautiful, I mean, you look at the colours on this fish if I hold them in the light. Those amazing blues and purples. Stunning, stunning fish. Whoa! And powerful too. Okay, we'll get these lures back in, eh, boysies?
I'm going in for a swim.
Is that a jackmack? Oh, that's a stunning bait. Live bait tank on.
Boy, marlin has been feeding on, mate.
Is that a bite? Yeah, no, we're bit on this lure. Well, I probably snagged it. Yeah. Foul hook on a marlin lure.
Jack mackerel, foul hook.
Jack mackerel, really foul hook. Good size hook per fish.
This is completely awesome. What is here? All of this fish. I've got to go and take a look. And I'm going to take this so you guys can check it out too. Those jack mackerel, they're in big trouble. Big trouble. I'd love a go at that, man. That was awesome.
Surfing,
you look, there's a huge shoal here. There's a shoal we're about to run over, but all around us, as far as you can see across this oily calm sea, is packs of tons of these mackerel. This is the food that sustains the ocean. Sometimes you wonder how predators like marlin can sustain themselves being so huge, so powerful and fast moving, needing all that energy. Well, I mean, look at all the food they've got. This is amazing.
Oh, we've got one on. Come on. Look at my Maggie throw.
He's so thick, a foul hook in them.
Dinner on!
Now, of course. And what do you know? It's another albacore. Now, just something I should point out, being towards the end of the day, and we want to keep a couple of these to eat, if you're going to be keeping your albacore to eat, the best way to get the blood out of them is just to give them a little stab on the lateral line there. Now, if you're squeamish, look away, because they really pump that blood out. Now, that's going to let all that blood out, and that's going to give us more meat, and I'm going to get this fella straight onto ice. Look at these, hauling them in, hand over fist. Starting to get a few of these boys. Wonder how we're going to process all of these tuna. I've got an idea. You know, just the usual sort of stuff.
What about some of this?
Oh, mate, that is perfect. Hey, look, I'm in a real hurry, mate, because the weather's perfect for, you know, cleaning up my yard, so I'll get it back to you tomorrow.
Okay, it's brand new there, so look after it, eh?
Yeah, mate, no worries. I'll look after it. This is probably the most common use in New Zealand for skipjack tuna, and that is snapper bait. But traditionally you get frozen skipjack, but if you catch it fresh like this piece here, it is hard to come by a better snapper bait. It is so oily, you can use the frames for burley, and in fact the albacore, the skipjack tuna, excellent bait and excellent burley. All right, hit it, Pete. Sensitive to noise? No worries. Come on. Oh, not bad. Not bad for a starter. First bait into the Burley Trail. Might be a carbine. The old strip of skipjack tuna. See all those hard hours dodging marlin, or trying to dodge marlin, to catch skipjack tuna is worth it. We might catch a feeder fish to take home. What have we got? Oh, it's a big trevally, is it? Or a rat kingfish? Whoa, rat kingy. Took a dead bait, it's unusual. Still, it's nice to be hooked up. It's a change from the summer of game fishing. Oh, you get such a scrap out of these little kingies. They've obviously responded to our burley trail. Here he is. Trying to get his head up. Okay, we'll get him on the deck. Get his eyes covered up and I'll just swap that hook out. Another stunning little kingie going back to fight another day, and there's no shortage of tuna for him to eat out there. Right, time for some more burley, Pete. Kick her in the guts, mate. You got him on over there. Hopefully a snapper. Hopefully a snapper. Spotting straight up and down, eh? Oh yeah, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that, Pete. Look at that. Yes. The burley, eh?
Yeah.
Beautiful, mate. That's a
Thank
stunning eater.
Much.
So that's payoff for catching all those skipjack tuna. Although skipjack and albacore are good eating in their own right, particularly albacore. But we just like snapper fishing, don't we, Pete?
That's right, mate.
Now, basically what we're doing here is we've got our wood chipper that's just fired tons of burley out there, and it's floating away mainly on the surface and slowly floating down. So we're straylining baits back that's sort of floating along in amongst all of that. And what we're hoping is for some bigger snapper. And well, me and Pete have been catching a couple of smaller ones. I've got Jeff rigged up on the 24-kilo tackle, holding tight. And I said, just be patient. Put out that big bait once the burley starts working and you might have a good shot at that 20 pounder.
Hopefully. Patience.
You picked up. Here we go. Brownie. Ferocious stroke for Pete. Ferocious. Mate, you're going to want the bottom to slow down, mate, or if you are going to let him go, you'll be blown up. Oh, nice. Nice pen. Oh, Jeff's got a good one.
Oh, yeah.
Bit of a run. Give him. You're not going to break the line. Go to sunset, mate. That's a donkey. Oh, you run you to the ground. That was a donkey, mate. That was a donkey. No worries, still down there, mate. Well, you might not see him again, but there might be another big one. Mate, deuce, 80 pound tray smashed. And Jeff just got cleaned up on 24 kilo tackle, and I'm gonna cast out my 8 kg tackle. There you go, Pete, there you go. Show him. Smash olid, mate.
I think it busted off me.
Yeah, running to the ground. Oh, something's hitting my strip baits. Got him on. I'm getting smoked, man. I'm getting smoked. This is a donkey, mate. This is a donkey. Oh no, I've got no show. I'm gonna get smashed. He's on the bottom now. On this light gear. This is gonna be tough. How that fish hasn't rubbed me off already, I don't know. Come on, hold on. It's holding together somehow. Come on, baby. Oh, mate, look at all the fish swimming around in our burley trail. Stalemate at the moment, I can't lift them. What if it's a shark? Oh, we're a big, big donkey snapper. If it is a snapper, mate, it's huge. Excuse me, I'm going to have to come over the wood chipper. Over the wood chipper. He's heading up towards the anchor, might be a big king. Oh, well. No one else got the nod. Yeah. Mate, how this braid held together, I don't know. I think a lot of credit's got to go to this gear. The smooth drag of the Trinidad and these T-Curve T-Series rods. It's just sort of not doing a snapper thing at the moment. Sort of just a heavy weight on this gear. Whoa, just dug in. Oh, I can see it down there. It's big, whatever it is. It's blooming big. Oh, it's a stingray. It's a ray. How could I handle that on this gear? Awesome. Just shorten them right up. We'll get a look at them, see what sort of ray he is. Just grab that sinker and cut that second hook so he doesn't get stuck with that hook feet. If you can, just push him on your rod. Watch, you don't get your hook in your hand. Okay, nice and close to him, so he has a fair fighting chance. The old stingray, watch that tail, mateys. And away he goes. Whew, that was a bit of fun on the skier, mate.
Yeah.
Here's this. Can handle a bit of load. Stoked. Pete, ferocious stroke from Pete. Go, Pete! Right. Stay with him! There's some donkeys down there. That's still smoking line out, mate.
Yeah, mate.
Oh, shivers. Mate, they're smashing into those big chunks of skipjack tuna and albacore tuna we're throwing down. Oh, that's smoking. You just gotta hang on and hope, mate. Okay, tighten it. You're not getting any wines there, mate. You're not getting any wines. Oh, mate, actually, you might have rolled them over. Keep going, keep working them. Oh, get the facial. Gotta get those facials. Come on, baby. Oh, you got him off the bottom, have you?
Yeah.
Wanna grab that net, Jeffrey? He might have a chance here, actually. I thought he was gone for all money on that first run.
Yeah, mate.
What do we got? Snapperoonie. Oh, it's a nice one. Jeez, that was a powerful fish. It was a goer. Oh, nice one.
Grab that bait, mate, he was gone.
Yeah, oh, mate, that was a screamer.
Yeah.
Mate, and they're just getting bigger and bigger.
Nice fish, that.
That is a very nice one.
The fillets off him.
Oh, here we go, on me. Something's picked up my bait.
Oh, ferocious strike.
Oh, got a wood chipper in me road. Great for attracting snapper. Not so good once you're hooked up to them. Every boat should have one though.
Whoa, yeah!
What a sesh. What a sesh. Mate, this is a smash. Every bait's getting smashed, mate.
Yeah.
Now, you've seen how it was done. All we started with was a couple of those little wee skippy lures and some hand lines. Whoa. And while they're great sport in their own right, they obviously make pretty good bill and bait.
Oi,
oi. It's a kingfish. Scrounging around down there on the bottom with the snappers, that one.
Now, just watch me rod.
Cheers, mate. I'll just. You're right, there's two hooks there, mate, so be careful.
Burley's working well, mate.
Well, a few more bigger ones soon, hopefully. Well, the fishing slowed down a wee bit now, and I think that's largely due to the fact that our burley trail has died down. There was a whole flurry of fish, our underwater cameramen saw a snapper and all sorts of stuff feeding down there now. So we better get it cranked up. picked up. Here we go. Oh, you over here, look. Oh, yeah, you got him, Jeff. There's a nice one.
Yeah. Oh, mate. Oh, you got him on, all right.
It's on, little fella.
Is he? Well, he's on 24 kilo line, mate, so he's going to have no show getting away. Oh, only little, you were saying. Get him off the bottom, buddy. Now, you may remember Jeff here trying to catch his first 20-pounder on our show. Well, he's done a few firsts on our show, his young Jeff. First marlin, widest first marlin. Yeah. And I've just rigged him up a 24 kilo set and said, mate, if you get the big one on, ain't going nowhere. It's a snapper, mate, it's a nice one, I'm telling you that much. Well, it's fighting up and down. Is it fighting up and down? Is it consistently pulling the
rat kingy, eh?
Might be a kingy.
Coming right under the coat.
Yeah, you're right, mate, there you go. Getting another run over here. We got a wood chipper in the road of the cameraman. You're all right. Not your traditional snapper fishing setup, but hey, it's paying dividends. Oh, mate, this is just no quarter. This fish hasn't been given a chance to run. 24 kilo gear, lock and load, dog. That fish still got heaps of fight today.
Ooh, it's a big one. This is gonna be a celebration.
Yeah. That's gonna go close to your 20 pound. Just take your time.
I think you got your. Think you got your 20 pounder, mate. There's your 20 pounder right there.
Get
out. There you go. All it took was about 70 or 80 kilos of skipjack tuna. What did I tell you when I made that rig up? That's the one that'll get the 20 pounder. And we'll just show you exactly what this rig is. This rig consists of a whole mackerel that we caught. Now what he's smashed up in those big powerful jaws there is a mackerel. He's got 2 9-bar-0 VMC hooks. We've got an 80 pound leader, and you'll notice how long the leader is. It's really, really long, right tied down onto this 24 kg line. When you're in gnarly, rocky country like we are here, this is the sort of gear you need to pull him away. And look how bulging his guts is. Now, it isn't spawning season right now. I'm picking, he's full of skipjack tuna.
I got my 20 pounder.
Yeah. Now you'll see here, this fish that pulverized this bait. Look at those sharp teeth up front, and those molars are crushing down back. And just a great big jack mackerel pulverized it. That's all that's left of a really big mackerel. And I said to Jeff, just bide your time. Then when the burley tide kicks off, there'll be some small fish around. There'll be some big ones working their way up, feeding on all that skipjack tuna. Now I'm just going to pick them up nicely for you, mate, so you can get a photo.
How good is that?
You ready? That is awesome, man. That looks awesome there, mate. Captured to savour forever. Now I'm just keeping this fish alive in the water here, just holding him in the net, just so we can get some water across his gills. Jeff is understandably stoked about catching his first 20 pound snapper. I'm sure it's going to go over 20. He says if it goes over 25, he wants to get a mount done, which so many guys do. They look stunning mounted on the wall. But of course, we need to weigh him. So if we get this, I'll weigh him in the net. Okay, and then we'll do them without the net. I don't think he's going to quite go 25, but there's only one way to find out for sure. Even with the net, he's not 25, mate.
Oh,
bugger. He's 11 kilos, so probably 10.5 without the net. So I would say 10.5 kilos, that's 21, 2.1, that's, geez, 23 and a half. Good fish, mate, but your call, mate.
Nah, sweet, chuck him back.
Let him go, good call. You put him back, mate, as your fish.
He starts feeling like he's going to come.
Well, our underwater cameraman's following him down. If he's not going to make it, well, he's going to bring him back to us. He can hold his breath for a long time.
Awesome.
How good was that, brother?
Awesome, hey? Man.
Hey?
Awesome, man. It was awesome to
let
him go.
Worth all those skippies? It's good to see them swim away. I mean, hey, it was your call totally, mate. But, you know, it gives you something to go for, that one on the wall. Now you've had a taste.
All good.
We're looking for something to eat. We're hunting, we're fishing, cause we like to eat fish and meat. Now we're cooking, we're cooking with Matt and Pete. It's cooking with Matt and Pete. It's cooking with Matt and Pete.
G'day, welcome to what is hopefully the last installment of Cooking with Matt and Pete.
today we've got a great recipe that is able to utilize our fresh albacore. I've got a couple of beautiful fillets here, some lemon and some pepper and salt. Ingredients that we'd probably expect to be in a fish dish. But we've got a couple of other very special ingredients that you might not expect to see. Namely cabbages and also some carrots. That's right, these are key ingredients in that dish that we all love, that family dish, coleslaw. So it doesn't take long at all to whip up. So Pete, if you'd like to go and get ready to serve up, I'm just gonna trim the dark meat out of these fillets. Now, we bled these albacore, so there's not a lot of this dark meat, but we take it out because we don't need any heat at all. We don't have to cook this meal. Right, now that is all our ingredients ready to go. Now, we're just about ready to combine everything, and this comes together beautifully. Presentation is key on this. Are you ready, Peter?
Yeah, mate.
We like to combine all of the ingredients at once so they blend together fairly nicely. The trick is to really keep things moving so you get a nice even blend of ingredients as they go through. Of course, the fish is key. A little bit of lemon juice just to offset the flavour. A little bit of zest as well. The whole lemon, in fact, the whole lemon can go in. And of course, a key ingredient to any good coleslaw is mayonnaise. Don't be shy to sort of lay it on. Nice and thick! A little bit of pepper and salt, just to taste. Is there enough salt in there, Pete? Fresh tuna coleslaw.
Bon appetit. It's good to be.